Well, boys, I finally did it. I finally got my dream car.
Are you ready?
Hey guys, my name is Kern and welcome back to Octane Street, the road here on YouTube that never ends. And not only does it never end, but, well, let's just say it's just getting started. So as you guys could see, I finally got my dream car. And before you guys start hating on me saying, how is this car your dream car? It's only a $10,000 plus car. What do you mean? Well, this is actually my dream car, albeit it's my attainable dream car. It's nothing crazy like a Ferrari 458 or whatever else might be on your guys' dream list. But this is my dream car and has been for over the past 15 years since this car actually came out in 2005, or rather this body style. I'll go ahead and throw up a picture right here for you guys to see. This is something I wrote for my teacher while I was in sixth grade, so when I was 11 years old, meaning 14 years ago, and I wrote this for my teacher, defining what success is. And to me, part of being successful meant having my very own 2005 to 2009 body style Mustang GT. Now, I wrote Mustang GT instead of Audi R8 or Lamborghini Mercy, whatever else, you know, big car was out at that time. I don't even think Mercy was out yet. It might have been, actually. But I wrote specifically Mustang GT, and that stuck with me ever since. This has been my dream car for the longest time, and I'm gonna be honest with you guys, I didn't just pick the car up today. I got the car about 3 days ago, and if it looks familiar to you guys, it actually should, because this is the same car that I went to go see in person, and I brought you guys along from a person named Martin. And after a couple months of going back and forth, we actually came to an agreement, and it was just a really, really special purchase for me, not only because it's my dream car, but because the bond that I had with the seller. It was a very unique and almost weird bond that I had with this person, because he shared his passion and his story with me behind his Mustang and why he bought it, when he bought it, what it meant to him. And honestly, we have a lot of similarities in not only how we grew up, where we grew up, but also, you know, what would have made us feel like we were successful. To him, this Mustang did that for him 10 years ago when he purchased it, and now it's doing the same thing for me in 2020. So with that being said, I want to give a huge shout out to Martin for not only sharing his story with me, but for being able to work with me and come to an agreement on a price that we both felt was fair and worked to both of our best interests. So for those of you wondering, I did end up getting the car for $10,300, which I personally think is a very fair price considering all the things that I need to fix on this vehicle. It does have 100,000 kilometers, 106,000 to be more specific, but don't worry, I'm definitely gonna make a video here in the near future talking about all the damages or things wrong with this vehicle, so definitely keep an eye out for that. But besides that video, there's gonna be a ton of content. Like I said, this is not only the road that is never ending here on YouTube, but is actually just beginning. I finally got my dream car, and like I said, I didn't just get it yesterday. I got it 3 days ago, and I'm making this video late because something really strange happened to me when I got this vehicle. I was extremely happy. I felt like I had accomplished a lifelong goal of mine. Think about it, for more than half of my life, I wanted this vehicle. It has been on my mind for so long. And for over the past year, I've been looking at these Mustangs on local classifieds pretty much every single night. And when I finally got my own, it kind of, I almost felt drained. Like I didn't have the energy to make YouTube videos on it right away because it's, I mean, I don't know if it's normal for this to happen or anything like that. I don't know if there's a term for it, if it's psychological, but just having spent so much time looking for the right one, when I finally got it, it kind of just, my body felt like, okay, now we could relax, we could finally calm down, de-stress, because we finally got our dream car and we no longer have to look every single night for the right one. So I'm super grateful to Martin that, again, he shared a story, resonated with me, and was able to work on a price with me for this vehicle. I promised him I'm gonna take good care of it and fix it up and make sure I drive the hell out of it. And Martin, I promise you that is exactly what I'm gonna do. But for the rest of you guys, just to give you guys an idea of what I plan to do with this vehicle, pretty much everything under the sun. It's 106,000 kilometers. I know these motors could go up to 230,000, no problem, if you take care of it, maintain it. So that's plenty of time to have fun with this vehicle. And even then, when the motor gives in, I might just 5.0 swap it because I love this body style so much, you know, depending on how the shape is by then. But right now it's in pretty good shape. Again, that'll be for a future video. But I already have several mods for this vehicle. As a matter of fact, I already have a mod on there that I'm not gonna tell you guys, but it's a pretty big mod. I'll tell you guys that it is a $800 Canadian mod, okay? So I already installed that mod. That's in a video already coming to you guys. But without giving any further spoilers, I do have several hundred dollars worth of mods left to do in this vehicle in my hands already. So there's definitely going to be a lot of content coming on this vehicle. I know there's not too many S197 or early S197 owners out there on YouTube that currently still rock their 05 to 09 Mustang. And so if you guys know people who are looking for early S197 Mustang content, be sure to let them know that, hey, this guy just picked one up. He seems like he's really loved the car and wants to do a whole lot with it. And, you know, hopefully they could come and hang out too with me and, of course, with you guys. It's also important to get across that I plan to do all the work or as much of it as I can on my own without taking the car to a shop, just so I could get that bonding experience and learning experience with this vehicle, and so I could appreciate it more, and also kind of, you know, tag you guys along for those of you that may be picking one of these up and want to do some work on it yourselves as well. So no going to the shop unless I absolutely have to with this vehicle. And I'm hoping you guys can, of course, appreciate that as well. But not only that, I'm hoping that some of you guys could actually help me when I get stumped sometimes in the comments right below that like button. I cannot be happier to have this car. And honestly, driving it for the past 3 days has been so incredible. I let my wife drive it. She absolutely loves it. And we just absolutely feel like bosses whenever we roll up and roll around in this vehicle. So I know this has been a lot of talking. I just wanted to get you guys understand where the channel is going to be going now. I'm super excited. I hope you guys are as well. But before I end this video, I want to go ahead and send you guys off with this clip of my very first drive in my 2006 Mustang GT, okay? Keep in mind, I look like a crackhead because I was only on 1 hour of sleep. I only had 90 minutes of sleep that day. I had to go and pick up the Mustang, and it's because Martin called me in the morning a lot sooner than we expected the car to be ready to, you know, do the whole transfer. So I flew out of bed, got the check ready, and was just waiting to meet him. So I look like shit because I felt like shit, but don't judge me. Keep in mind, it's been quarantine lately, so your boy got a little big body. But yeah, this is my first drive. I hope you guys enjoy it, and I hope you guys are excited for what's to come on the channel. My name is Curran, this is Octane Street, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.
Wow. Oh my God, I feel so good. I actually feel so good. Jesus Christ. This thing, oh my God. I feel so happy.
North away.
I genuinely feel so happy. Jeez. It feels so different than the Velociraptor. So different. It feels so good. These cars are pretty heavy, but oh my God. It actually feels so good. Oh my god. It feels really good. It feels, honestly, like, I almost want to start crying. It feels so good. Like, it feels better than I thought it would. You know that? I swear to god.
How does it compare to the other Mustangs?
Honestly, I can't even think about those right now. I can't. I swear to god, I can't. It feels so good, man. Just putting your foot on the throttle even a little bit. I thought it would feel a little bit sluggish, but not at all. It doesn't feel sluggish at all. Sounds? That's a stock exhaust. Oh shit.
That's why you want the plates.
Yeah. I literally would have drove right past. Martin, you saved my ass. You saved my ass. I would have drove right past those bastards with no plates.
Yeah.
Jeez, you saved me, Martin. You did. You did me a solid. It's ridiculous.
Imagine what happens. This is with no cold air intake and exhaust.
I can't imagine.
Even a simple cold air intake.
I can't imagine. Oh my god. Just the rumble. You know what I'm talking about, right? When you put your foot on the throttle a little bit, it just rumbles, man.
That's the
VX. Mine feels so good. But that's alright. Hush.